Hello, I'm Dr. Ron England, and what I'm going to show here is how to create tabbed pages on the internet. And I'm going to show using, in this case, I'm going to show how to use the AJAX control within .NET to do that. So what does a tab dialog look like? Well, here's a picture of a tab dialog. In this case, I put three tabs, one of them being empty and two of them not being empty. And each tab actually operates essentially independently, but it gives you this capability of being able to have multiple forms up on the same page with the tab. And I think most people are very familiar with the use of tabbed systems that are tabbed like that. So let's look at how you do this. Now, this is the only way to create tabbed dialog pages. There's quite a few ways to do that. But I'm going to show you a technique that I use that's very effective. Now, I use specifically, when I do the tabs, I use the AJAX control. I'm going to pull it all the way up here. I use the AJAX control tab container. And I do have some other ways that I like to do it sometimes, but most of the time I'll use a tab container. And it's a relatively easy to use and relatively easy to maintain control for doing tab dialogs. So, and that's showing it within the toolbox. Now, here's what happens if you drop it onto the page. You're going to have right here a tab container. And the container contains multiple tab panels. And with each tab panel, you've actually got two sections here. You've got a content template, and you've also got a header template that you can put in too. So you can have both the content and the header for the individual tabs. Now, in this case, I'm only showing a content template and just simple header text, a very straightforward tab. But you can get into the more of the complexities as you move along. And within that tab panel, and you can have multiple tab panels, that content template, inside of here you put your content that you have, whatever forms, whatever controls you need fit within that content template. And in the way that I would normally use tab panels is so that I can manage the individual tabs very well, is I'll typically create a user control that contains all the functionality of what I want on that specific tab. And then I'll simply put that user control, drop that user control into the content template. Now, to do that, realize you have to register your user control. I typically use a tab prefix of UC that designates that I've got a user control, and then the name of that user control. But now I have access completely to those user controls. And because the user controls are essentially fully independent functioning pieces of code, I really don't have to worry too much about how they interact with the tab, other than I may have a button on the tab panel that's an additional button that allows you to navigate forward from one tab to another, which kind of gives you a type of wizard feel to it, because if you're on tab one, you can move on to tab two, and the tab panel one, tab panel two, and you can move forward with that. So as far as the code itself that's behind it, if I looked at the code, and you'll notice that there's not a tremendous amount of code here, and none of the code that I've actually got on here really does anything associated with the tab panel. That's one of the beauties of a tab panel, is it is in itself almost a fully functional piece of code. So nice thing about this is it's a very simple approach to take. It is part of the AJAX, library of AJAX controls that would be available to you within .NET, pretty much from 2.0 all the way up through the other versions of .NET. And as long as you understand the concept of having a tab container, which then encapsulates multiple tab panels, and each tab panel having its content templates, it's really that easy. Hopefully, you can easily get started with tab controls, and good programming.